Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of creating process, and in today's video we'll be designing this very cool sci-fi logo. And if you look at this logo, we have got a very nice black marble shiny stone in the background over which we have added this eco text, and then we have added the text signs. So to create this logo, we'll follow the following steps. First, we'll create this very smooth shape of the stone. Second, we'll add these shiny effect over it using the mesh tool. And third, we'll add these text. So let's begin with the tutorial. So we'll start with the ellipse tool and create a nice round circle. Fill this with some dark color, maybe black. Now select this object, go to object, envelope distort, and make with wrap. And using this option, we can create any kind of shape, like natural, smooth, any kind of shape. And there are multiple number of options here to create your shape, to distort your shape. So you can see that if I do that, and if I preview it, you can see it has formed multiple number of shapes here, like this wavy shape, arc shape. So for this logo, we'll use this shell upper, and we'll use these attributes to modify our shape. So we'll just move here. You can see with this, you can elongate from side by side, and I have kept horizontal. If I use it vertical, it will be something else. So I'm using horizontal so that I can do it, the adjustment horizontally. I can just move, push it up a little bit so that I can get this shape. That's, you can see the angles can be changed here. So we'll do that. Let's see. I think this is good. And we can click the OK button when you get that. So you can see we have got the exact shape here. And after that, the next thing is select this object, go to object and expand it so they convert it into fill object form. Now the next thing, will add the shiny effect over it, and to add that we'll use the mesh tool. So go to mesh tool, select the mesh tool, and let's add the mesh. So you can see here we need the glossy effect over here, so we'll add one here. We need a little glossy effect here, so we'll use that and add one here. And we'll add one here so that we can create that flow over here, so that we can add some finishing effect here. So after that, we'll add only this much of mesh, because if we add more, it is going to distort your color combination. So let's do that. Now with the direct selection tool, we'll select this one anchor point, and let's change the color. So let's give it some bright color. You can see that we have got a brighter tone. Now select these, and let's give it a little bit darker. Select this, a little bit more darker. Select this, a little bit more darker. This is going like a gradient, like a flow. Lightest to a little more darker. So, and after that, we need to add here some. So we'll select this, and let's add some lighter color here so that we can see that here. You can see, I think yeah, that's fine. And add this and a little bit here, this much. So we can reduce the darkness, light brightness here, like that. And after that, after doing that, the next step is to select all the corner points. Select all the corner points, and let's change the color altogether. So let's select all the corner points. Select like this. With the shift selected, you can select all the corner points. Go to color and fill it with dark color. So you can see we have created this dark tone at the edges, which has created some nice effect. Now we'll select this and we'll add some darker tone here also, so that we can get some gradual feel here. You can see that you can select this a little bit darker, and this one more darker, and this one most darkest. So you can see that, so it has created some sense of gradualness. This flow is cool. We have created a nice flow. Now after that, after creating this stone, the next thing is to add a text. So let's type out our text. text, that type. Eco. Now for this, for eco, we are using this myriad text. So I'll just select this with the app eco. You can see that this is the text we're going to use, this one, for this. And let's do some adjustment here. Let's add some black color for the stroke and increase the thickness, stroke thickness. So you can see I have thickened it. Now go to stroke and let's curve the corners. So you can see that after clicking this option, and the corners has been rounded. So we need that. Now let's bring it over here and let's do some more thing. Let's change this color to white, the stroke and both. So you can see we have created that. Now let's scale this down a little bit because it's a little bit bigger. And the thickness, I think the stroke thickness is quite large, so we can reduce it to, I think, 6. Let's see. Select it and reduce it to 6. You can test it, you can check it. If it's not, you can increase it with the up and down arrows. Yeah, that's fine. Now after that, you can see that this text is looking good. Let's scale this up a little bit. Now select this text, go to object and expand it. Select this object, expand, convert it to fill form, again twice expand it so that we can get it proper. Now go to pathfinder, combine all the pieces and convert this into single object. So you can see it is now single object. Now we'll add the gradient here, and for this I have already created a gradient color here, the white and little gray here. You can see if I go into the gradient option, it's like this white, white, and here in the corner we have added little gray too, so that we can feel some depth of field. So we'll add that. Select this object and with the eye picker I'll just select that gradient color. Now with the gradient tool I'll just do the adjustment here. So you can see if I remove it, you can see it feels like this text is, there's a hole in the stone which has been like the text, and there's a shadow feel that creates some depth here. Now the last thing is to add this text, and let's type out that text. So for this we are using this text Ravi, and let's just convert this into object form. Go to object, expand it. Now ungroup it. We are doing this because we need to do a little bit of adjustment here. So we need to remove this and now group this up. Ctrl G. We don't need that I dot. And now after that we can add the color. So with the Apica, we'll select this color. And with the gradient tool, we'll just play with the gradient. If you see here, it's a dark orange and lighter orange. So we can see the gradual flow here in the text also. Now if we are finished it, we can just scale it up to fit with our logo. Now place it there. So you can see we have finished our sci-fi logo. We have created this nice looking stone with a glossy effect. We have added this text which feels like there's a hole on the stone and this text. So hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.